गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू, वेलकम बैक टू कोर्स सॉप कंप्यूटिंग. सो इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फजी इन्फरेंस सिस्टम. सो इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट द फजी इन्फरेंस रूल. सो देयर वी डिस्कस हाउ टू फॉर्मुलेट द फजी रूल, व्हाट आर द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द फजी रूल. So and also we have seen how fuzzy rule play a very important role in a fuzzy logic system. So in today's video we are going to discuss about fuzzy inference system. What is fuzzy inference system and how this fuzzy inference system is important in a SOP computing, or you can say in the fuzzy logic. So let's discuss fuzzy inference system. So fuzzy inference system is a system, or you can say that it's a process of mapping input to output with the help of fuzzy logic. So the funda is very clear. In this case you are converting fuzzy input to the output, but with the help of what? Fuzzy logic. By application of fuzzy logic you are converting your input to the output, and for that purpose what we required a fuzzy inference system. So this fuzzy inference system will make use of the various concepts. First is a membership function, second one is a fuzzy logic operator, and third one is a if then else rules. These three components play very important role in the formation of a fuzzy inference system, because fuzzy inference system is based on these three important components. Membership function play very important role while converting fuzzy value to crisp value, and crisp value to fuzzy value. Fuzzy logic operators are also important, because once we apply operator, then that state may get changed. And if then rules are again important, because everything is working based on the rule. Generally fuzzy inference system is being used in a embedded system. Fuzzy inference system mostly used in a embedded system, just like your washing machine, microwave, oven. These are the some example where fuzzy inference system is being used. And again, the scope of fuzzy inference system is not limited to embedded system, but it is also used in automatic control, data classification, decision analysis, expert system, and computer vision. There also you can make use of this fuzzy inference system. This fuzzy inference system, as it is a multidisciplinary in nature, so it is being known by different terms. Fuzzy inference system is known by different terms that we are going to discuss over here. Fuzzy inference system is also called as a fuzzy rule based system. It is also being identified as a fuzzy expert system, or you can also say it is a fuzzy model, or you can say fuzzy associative memory, or fuzzy logic controller, or you can say that it's a simple fuzzy system. So these are the different name by which you can identify fuzzy inference system. Now let's discuss the block architecture of the fuzzy inference system. So we'll try to understand this block architecture with the help of example, because example is the best way to understand a particular concept. Now let's take a simple example of a washing machine. I just focus on the embedded system, that in case of embedded machines mostly fuzzy logic is used. So we have chosen the washing machine. How washing machine works? So in case of a washing machine, what you are providing? You are providing cloth as an input and you are getting cloth as output. But we have seen the definition of fuzzy inference system. It tried to map input to the output, but with the help of fuzzy logic. So in case of washing machine, input is a cloth, output is a cloth, but the thing is that your input cloth is a dirty one and your output cloth is a clean one. And we already understand the difference between the crisp value and the fuzzy value. Fuzzy, so in that case we are using first of all dirty cloth to the washing machine. So dirty is a fuzzy word. Why dirty is a fuzzy word? Because you can't say that directly dirty. You cannot define the dirty directly. So in that case sometimes you are providing the cloth which are not that much dirty, because we know that crisp value means either 0 or 1. It already it considered as a dirty, or it considered as a clean. But suppose particular cloth is 30% dirty, so what you can say? Can you say it is a dirty or clean? So obviously you are saying dirty. So in order to measure the dirtiness, you should have value between 0 and 1. Only 0 and 1 is not means it's not good that only you have the value 0, 1, but your value should be between 0 to 1. The value should varies between the value should varies between 0 and 1. That dirtiness can be measured in terms of 0. It is 30% dirty, 40% dirty, 50%, 60%, 70%. So in that ways, you are providing the input to the fuzzy inference system. Once you are providing dirty cloth as an input to the washing machine, but the thing is that your washing machine directly will not understand it. Okay, because fuzzy inference system only understand the fuzzy value. It will not understand the crisp value. That's why what you have to do, you have to make use of a fuzzifier. Fuzzifier is that component in the fuzzy inference system which converts your crisp value to the fuzzy value. Now in this case, what we are doing, we are providing dirty cloth as an input. Now in the fuzzifier, what you are doing, your washing machine will decide how much dirty particular cloth is. Okay, so that means you are converting your dirty cloth, you are converting the crisp value to the what value? Fuzzy value. And then that fuzzy value given as an input to this fuzzy logic controller or fuzzy inference system. Okay, or you can say inference engine. And this inference engine have two component. This fuzzy inference engine is we can say it's like a brain of fuzzy inference system which controls all the components involved in fuzzy inference system. So it will take the help of knowledge base. And in case of knowledge base, you have two components. One is a database and second one is a rule base. So your database, in your database, what you have in database, you are going to store the membership function. Whereas in case of your rule base, you are going to store the different rules. Okay, in case of a rule base, you are storing the rules, and in case of a database, you are storing the membership function. So membership function is useful while converting the crisp value to fuzzy value, and also while converting the fuzzy value to crisp value. At the time, membership function is useful, and at the same time, you also require the rules. Now, in case of washing machine, how will you formulate the rules? You can formulate the rules just like that. Suppose the weight of the cloth is 5 kg, that means in that case you can say if the weight of the cloth is 5 kg, then you required 5 liters of water. If the weight of the cloth is 5 kg, then you required 5 spoons of detergent. If the weight of cloth is 5 kg, then you required a minimum 30 minutes for cleaning. So such type of rules can be used in case of a washing machine, and that rules will be stored in the rule base. So your fuzzy inference system will make use of this knowledge base to process the crisp value. To process that fuzzy value. Okay, that fuzzy value is being processed by fuzzy inference system, and after that you are getting the output. But that output is what? Fuzzy value. Again, the particular customer will not understand this fuzzy value. They want the value in the crisp. So a defuzzifier comes into existence which converts your fuzzy value to crisp value. Now in terms of washing machine, what you can say, your washing machine will clean the cloth, but again you can't say that your cloth is 100% clean. So in that case you can say 90% clean, 80% clean, 75% clean, like this. Okay, that's why you need to convert this into a crisp value again. Okay, means whatever it may be to you, it is clean. Means normal user can't understand that this is that much clean. You can say either it is dirty or you can say either it is clean. So for that purpose, your washing machine, it has to convert this fuzzy value to again back to the crisp value. So in this way, fuzzy inference system is used in a washing machine. Okay, in a washing machine to map the input to output with the help of fuzzy logic. Now we'll try to understand the working of each and every component in detail. very first you are making use of fuzzifier. Just as told you about fuzzifier, the thing is that your fuzzy inference system will not understand crisp value. It only understand the fuzzy value. Just like that, your computer system or your machine only understand the binary value, but they will not understand the high level value. That's why you use compiler to convert high level language to the machine level language. Similarly, in case of fuzzy inference system, fuzzy value is that fuzzy inference system will only understand the fuzzy value. So first component comes into existence, that is a fuzzifier, which converts your crisp value to fuzzy value with the help of membership function. In this case, membership function play very important role, which help you to converts your to which help you to convert the crisp value to the fuzzy value, which is understandable by your inference system. Then next you have inference engine. Okay, so inference engine will make use of knowledge base. So that knowledge base is, just we have seen in case of knowledge base, two sub components are there. One is a database and second one is a rule base. So database will store membership function. Membership function is used while fuzzification as well as while defuzzification. So all these membership function is stored in the database, whereas in case of a rule base, we are storing different rule. We have just taken example of washing machine. So in that case, we are storing the rules related to washing machine, that weight of the cloth is that much, then you have to use that much amount of water, that much amount of detergent, that much amount of time is required. So similarly, you can formulate the rule, and that rules are stored in the rule base. So your fuzzy inference engine will make use of all these kinds of rule to process the input, okay, to process that fuzzy value, which is converted by fuzzifier. Fuzzifier has converted the crisp value to the fuzzy value, and then processing is done by fuzzy inference system. So in terms of washing machine, you can say that cleaning process is done by this inference engine, okay, and after that you are getting the output. So in this case, we have shown you the diagrammatic representation. You are providing the cloth as an input, you are providing crisp value as an input, then set of rules are there. Each rule will generate some kind of output. All these output are aggregated, and then you will get a fuzzy output over here. Okay. Now, after getting fuzzy output, the thing is that you need to convert that fuzzy output again to the crisp output, because initially you have taken the crisp value, so finally you need to return it to customer. Just like a compiler will converts your high level language to the machine level language, then processing will be done, and again finally user will get the output in the high level language itself. So in the same way, in case of fuzzy inference system, you have two component. One is a fuzzifier, and exactly opposite to that fuzzifier there will be defuzzifier. So what is the role of defuzzifier? Actually, defuzzifier is going to converts your fuzzy value to the crisp value. What fuzzifier has done? Fuzzifier has converted crisp value to fuzzy value. Now fuzzy value is converted to crisp value by the defuzzifier, and defuzzifier also make use of membership function. That's why we are focusing on membership function, which is stored in the database, in the knowledge base, because this membership function is useful in the process of fuzzification as well as defuzzification. So in defuzzifier, what we are doing, we are converting our fuzzy value to the crisp value. So there are various methods are available for defuzzification. What are the different methods? Just for the clarity, I have mentioned few methods. Centroid of an area, this is one of the method. Bisector of an area, this is another method. Mean of maximum is another method. Smallest of maximum and largest of maximum. These are the various method which is used to convert the fuzzy value to the crisp value, and that is being used in the defuzzification. So in this way, this fuzzy inference system works. So I hope you understand what is fuzzy inference system. We have explained it with the help of a washing machine example, and explain all the components involved in the fuzzy inference system. Thank you.